Welcome to you from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will discuss different conformations of ethane. Now, if you're watching this playlist, this video is part of a playlist. In the previous video, we ended with the idea of what are Newman projections, and we drew a Newman projection of ethane, and that's actually where we start right here. This is a Newman projection of ethane. We're looking down the carbon 1, carbon 2 bond. We can't see carbon 2 because it's behind carbon 1, but this is a Newman projection of ethane. Now, let's imagine that we can put sticky notes on some of these hydrogens. Let's put a sticky note on this hydrogen, and we'll give it a star. And then also this hydrogen, which is actually attached to carbon 2. And let's say we then rotate the sigma bond, the carbon 1, carbon 2 sigma bond. And we're going to rotate this by 60 degrees. That hydrogen is going to move. This hydrogen, which is also on carbon 2, is going to move. And that hydrogen is going to move. The front carbon hydrogens are going to stay fixed. So here is the same hydrogen on carbon 1. This is now where that hydrogen on carbon 2 landed. And again, we're rotating by 60 degrees. And we get a new Newman projection. And we can continue this rotation. Let's keep on rotating these hydrogens. And that would get us to this structure. No, it looks just like the first one, except this hydrogen at top hasn't moved, but this is where that original hydrogen has now moved to. And if we keep doing this process, let's rotate some more, another 60 degrees. Let's fill these in, 60 degrees. Then we finally get to here. So we've now created or accounted for four different Newman projections. Now, when we talk about these angles, we're actually talking about dihedral angles. And I show these at the bottom left of the screen. We've talked about bond angles, and bond angles of 109.5 if it's sp3 hybridized and 120 if it's sp2. But now we're talking about dihedral angles. And for dihedral angles, we need to refer to the position of atoms on adjacent atoms. So we need three bonds to define this. And these three bonds are a lot like the CH on carbon 1, then going to carbon 2, and then the CH on carbon 2. And that's how we come up with these angles. So for this particular Newman projection, the angle between those two hydrogens, and I've run out of space to color, is 0 degrees. Now the separation, this dihedral, is 60 degrees. This dihedral between the two starred or sticky note hydrogens is 120. And this dihedral is now 180. And we can refer to these on an energy axis. And we can think of this as a process of kind of moving through time as we rotate around this dihedral and create these dihedral angles. As it turns out, energetically, the dihedral angle of 0 is higher in energy. As we go to 60, it goes to 0 in a relative sense. As we go to 120, it comes back up to about 3 kcal per mole. And down to 180. Well, what this tells us is these different conformations are not of identical energies. Some are higher than the other. So in this, if this is 3 kcal per mole, what is the source of that energy? Well, the source of that energy is actually the fact that we're bringing these bonds, this electron density, close in proximity. And this is called torsional strain. This is a repulsion between electrons that are in these bonds. And that gives a repulsion. And there are three of these torsional strain interactions. Boom, boom. And each one of those has a cost. It's 1 kcal per mole for each of these what we call hydrogen-hydrogen eclipsing interactions. So there's a cost of bringing that electron density in close proximity. It's a repulsion energy. We call this torsional strain. And this is really the main outcome of this slide. We've learned that when you rotate about the C-C bond in ethane, we get a repulsive force, and each of these hydrogens repels, and it has a cost of 1 kcal per mole. So since there are three of these repulsions, we get a total energy cost of 3 kcal per mole. When we rotate these away and get to this kind of structure, we alleviate that strain, and we go back to a low zero-point energy. This conformation, the leftmost conformation, is called an eclipsed conformation. And when we have dihedral angles of 60 degrees, we call this a staggered conformation. So we will frequently refer to other molecules and we'll say things are eclipsed or staggered. This structure where we go, this particular Newman projection is also eclipsed, and this last one is also staggered. So this is how we talk about these conformations and use Newman projections to communicate about conformations of molecules.